Does any of this sound strange? Hospitals, synagogues, ecstasy, I don't know. Believe me, it just gets stranger. The next person I have to thank is Liz Rosenberg. I know she's also here somewhere. Yeah. She's been and still is the head of publicity for my entire career. Now, does anybody understand the insanity of being my publicist for the last 25 years? Yeah. Well, I think Liz was smoking a joint when I first met her. Yeah. Yeah. I walked into her office and she very politely stubbed it out in the ashtray. I don't think she thought I knew she was smoking a joint, but it was a little bit obvious. Anyway, we hit it off right away. She was my kind of girl, tough, irreverent, and funny. And we've had a long and amazing chunk of time together. God. after dealing with all the nutcases she's had to deal with and putting out all the fires that she's had to put out, it's kind of amazing that she's not shooting up heroin. I don't mean to grass everybody up and make it sound like everybody I hooked up with was like a drug addict or anything, but the fact of the matter is, or the reality is that I ended up with a group of very responsible and hardworking people who gave me an enormous amount of love and support, along with everyone else at my record company. And I don't have time to thank all of you, but thank you. So then, of course, I needed a manager, right? So I asked myself, self, who is the most successful artist in the business today? And self answered, Michael Jackson. So off I went to LA to find the man who managed Michael Jackson, to make him my manager. Cut to Freddie DeMann. Another man I want to thank, the ultimate Mac Daddy manager, slick back hair, tan, smelling of expensive cologne, big desk, smoking a cigar. Yep, he drove a Porsche. He gave me a ride back to my hotel in that Porsche. By the time we got there, he was my manager. And there was no monkey business, okay? He gave me... I'm just kidding. See, he rubbed off on me. This speech was not meant to have a lot of sexual innuendos, somehow. He's bringing sexy back. Okay. I'll get you, fucker. Okay, so we had an amazing 15 years together, and I learned a lot from him, so thank you, Freddie DeMann. It is while I was with Freddie that I met this incredibly cocky Israeli teenager named Guy Osiri. He was like Freddie's step and fetch it boy. Yeah. He was always putting his two cents in, even when, and especially when, I didn't ask for it. He was the most ambitious, confident, idealistic, hungry for knowledge, obsessed with money 18-year-old I'd ever met. He kept pestering me with his ideas. He never stopped scheming. He was relentless. And today, he is my manager. And I know that he would fly to the ends of the earth for me. So thank you, Guy. And as you can see, everything kind of goes full circle here, doesn't it? But what's a record without the music, right? That's right, motherfuckers. What's a record without Nile Rodgers, Pat Leonard, Babyface, Joe Henry, William Orbit, Mirwais Amatse, Stuart Price, Pharrell, and now Justin Timberlake and Timberland? I feel so lucky to have been able to work with such amazing songwriters and producers. I can't underestimate how grateful I am for that. I would also like to thank all of my fans who have stuck by me through thick and thin. God knows they've stuck by me, yes. Now be quiet. Now they've stuck by me through thick and thin, and God knows there's been a lot of thick. That's not an innuendo. I'd also like to thank the Semtex girls, who are my soldiers, and I know they would walk through the fire with me. Thank you, ladies. To my teachers, my friends, and my family, I thank you all for facilitating this journey, which for me has only just begun, and for reminding me that I am only the manager of my talent, not the owner. I've gone on to do so many things in my life, from writing children's books to designing clothes to directing a film. But for me, it always does and it always will come back to the music. So thank you very much. Now, I would now like to introduce another ass kicker from Michigan, Iggy Pop.